guys. It's Lisa with Inbalance Yoga. This is our first live stream class on Instagram, but also we'll have stuff posted on YouTube as well coming up here. Just going to take a couple minutes so people can start to log in and get on their mat, get settled. We are going to start in a comfortable seat. So once you get onto your mat, find Sukhasana, easy seat. Start to root the sit bones down. So feel the earth underneath you and start to lift and lengthen through the spine. So you find all this beautiful length, lengthen through the back of the neck. Draw the shoulders and the shoulder blades down the back and close the eyes. And just start to allow the breath to move you inward. Feel yourself expand with every inhale. And there's a slight contraction with every exhale. Keep moving inside. And take a look inside. Imagine you're shining a flashlight into all the spaces and places that never get seen, where we hide and store stuff. Imagine taking the breath to those places. Allowing movement. Allowing release. So in this time of uncertainty, a little bit of chaos, I want to come back to something that is happening even through the chaos. We are experiencing spring. So tomorrow is actually spring equinox. And if we can take a moment to have gratitude and to enjoy all things spring, the flowers blossoming, the new grass pushing through the earth, baby chicks, bunnies, rain, wind. Some of you in Salt Lake got snow. So enjoying and appreciating our spring. From here, take a big inhale through the nose, fill up, expand, grow. And then just part the lips and exhale through the mouth. Again, inhale, fill up. Part the lips, let it go. Last time. Hold at the top. Open the mouth. Let go. Awesome. Reconnect with the breath. Allowing it to take you inside. Since we don't have our external heat, keep the lips closed and start to pull in your Ujjayi Pranayama breath. So a slight constriction on the back of the throat, inhaling and exhaling through the nose. It'll serve to warm the body from the inside out. And when you're ready, blink the eyes open. And start to take the right arm, crawl over to the right. Plant the hand down, maybe bend the elbow slightly. Left arm lifts, spin the pinky towards the front. And then reach up and over. Really root through your left sit bones. Press out through your left rib cage. Right shoulder down the back. Maybe start to bend the elbow. Some of you are going to be able to bring your forearm to the mat. Some of you are going to be hovering like me. If this hurts the neck at all, you can always look down. If you want a little more support, take the hand to the side of the ear. And and reach up. I even like to press my head back, really reach through the elbow. Good. Breaking up all this congestion that we carry in our side bodies. Inhale through center. Release the left arm. Crawl the left fingertips over to the left. Reach the right arm up. Spin the pinky finger forward. Start to bend the left elbow. Root through the right sit bone and stretch through the right ribs. And as you breathe here, you'll start to notice space starts to open. You'll be able to go into the pose a little bit deeper, bending the elbow, maybe even landing it onto the mat. Remember, if the neck feels a little bit heavy, bring the hand to the side of the ear. Press the head back, reach up with the elbow, root through the left sit bone. Good, come back up through center. Crawl yourself forward. Send the tailbone back. So you'll feel this in the shin, the leg that's in the front. You'll feel this in your outer hip. So fold forward and then just slightly shake the tailbone. Allow the shaking to move all the way up the spine and through the crown of the head. We'll use this technique throughout the class for release to create space. Good. Crawl the fingertips back towards the shin. Cross the opposite shin in front. We're going to twist now. So right hand supports the spine. Left hand grabs the knee. Sit up super tall. So find the space in the spine and imagine your heart is moving up towards the sun like a flower that's blooming. So lift through the chest and twist. Belly pulls in and up. Lots of space in the low back. Every inhale, lengthen. Every exhale, twist. One more breath. Lift the heart to the sun. And turn through center. Switch sides. Left hand supports. So this left arm is giving you lots of space to your lumbar spine. Right hand to the left knee. Sit up nice and tall. Pull out of the low back and twist. Crown of the head reaches up, heart reaches towards the sun. Every inhale, lengthen. Every exhale, revolve. One more breath. Turn forward through center. Again, crawl the fingertips forward. So get to the opposite outer hip now. You can pop up onto the fingertips or palms can be flat, but just get that stretch through the outer hip. Start to shake from the tailbone. Good, and then walk the hands back towards the shins. Make your way into a downward facing dog. So plant the hands, step back, down dog. Spread the fingers wide. Grip the mat with the fingertips and pinch the mat with the thumb and first finger. From here, lift up through the forearms so there's a little bit of space. Wrap the triceps towards the floor and then keep that so the upper back is nice and broad. Press the heart back. Pull the belly in and up, pull the ribs in, tailbone lifts, press the thigh bones back. From here, walk the inner feet towards each other and lift the right leg high. Roll the right pinky toe down towards the floor. Lift from the inner right thigh up. Then lift the left heel high. As you lift the left heel high, you'll notice that your hips go up, but keep your hips square. Press through the heels of the hands to lift the hips even higher. And then with the strength of the leg, lift the leg a little higher. Good, again, press through the heels of the hands, lift the hips, leg lifts. Lower the heel. Open the hip, bend the knee, stretch. Try not to dump through this left shoulder, lift up. Good. Square the hips off. Lower the foot to the mat. Come forward into plank pose. In your plank pose, we're going to protract the shoulders. So press through the hands and round through the upper back. So wrapping the shoulder blades around the ribs. Then melt the heart down and forward towards the thumbs. Again, round. And then melt. Three more. Round. And melt. two more round, and melt. Keep gripping the floor with the fingertips. Last time, round. Protract the shoulders, press the ground away, and then pull the heart through. Lift the hips up and back, down dog. If you walk your feet out from each other, walk them back to touch. And then inhale, lift the left leg high. Roll the left pinky towards the floor, and the inside of the left thigh lifts up towards the ceiling. Lift the right heel high. Press through the heels of the hands to lift the hips. Keep the hips square. Lift the leg about an inch more. Again, press through the heels of the hands to lift the hips, lift the leg. Leg is square. So it's like you're pressing a blade of grass through the dirt. Lots of effort. Lower the heel, open the hip, bend the knee, stretch it out. You can take circles with the ankle, pop up through that right armpit, knee lifts high, stretch. So this is the feel-good portion, yeah? Good. And then square the hips off, lower the foot to the mat, come forward plank pose. Good. Again, five times, press the ground away, round, protract. Good. Then melt the heart, drop it forward. Good. Again, round. And melt to the thumbs. And round. Bring the hands by the ribs. Clip all 10 toenails into the mat, even the pinky toes. So feel your inner thigh roll up towards the ceiling. Press the pelvic bowl down. Inhale, lift up, cobra. Exhale, lower. Again, hold the heart forward. Inhale, cobra pose. Exhale, lower. Last time, inhale, cobra. Squeeze elbows and pull up. Exhale, lower. Repeat cobra pose, or now find upward facing dog, press into the hands, tops of the feet, pull the shoulders back, heart to the sun. Every time you find a heart opener, it's to the sun. Exhale, downward facing dog. Take a breath, big inhale, and exhale. One more time, come forward into plank pose. You know, we can't skip these, in my class anyway. So we're going to chaturanga, lower just halfway. Don't let the shoulders go beyond the elbows. Lift the shoulders up, heart up. Press back up, plank. Lift the hips up and back, down dog. So on the breath, plank pose, inhale. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, plank. Exhale, down dog. Last time, plank pose. Chaturanga. Plank. Down dog. Good. Walk the hands back to the feet. Lift the chin, lengthen through the spine, bend the knees. Grab opposite elbows and fold. Once you're folded, we're going to sway like that spring wind is blowing us. So the spring wind blows all the dead debris away. It almost has this like clearing, cleansing effect on the earth. So use the wind here for the body to sway, release.
find an organic place to stop the sway, stop in the center. Lift the fingertips, lengthen through the spine. Exhale, fold. This time, super soft, you're gonna make a rainbow. Paint a rainbow with the fingertips on the floor, on the mat. So you're just swaying from side to side, taking your arms with you. Yesterday was St. Patrick's Day, so today it's still a rainbow. Good. Pause in the center. Bend the knees a lot, let the head hang. Drop the tailbone and roll up vertebrae. Until you come all the way up to stand. So walk to the top of the mat, I'm going to face you just to set our intention. Hands to the heart and close the eyes. All right, so a couple things. This class is a lot of things spring, which is kind of fun. And just a nice reminder that there's other things going on in the world other than chaos. There is still order. And in nature there is order. But then also, I want you to think about spring cleaning. So a lot of times when I think about spring cleaning, I think about the hips and the body. So the hips are like our garage that gets super messy, or our junk drawer. And we're going to just shine a flashlight in there today, take a look, release some stuff, and spring clean a little bit. So, from here, take a big inhale through the nose. Open the mouth, exhale, seal it, and send your love to all the other people watching the class. Love and support. We're still a community, you guys. Walk to the top of the mat. Surya Namaskar, A. Inhale, reach the arms up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, lift the chin, heart forward, step back, plank pose. Chaturanga, lower halfway. Inhale, upward facing dog, shoulders back. Exhale, downward facing dog. Just one breath, big inhale. Big exhale. Lift the heels, bend the knees, step lower flat. Feet to the hands, lengthen through the spine. Exhale, squeeze the belly, curl the chin, fold. Inhale, reach the arms up. Clasp the hands, release the index fingers. Root through your left foot, reach up, and over press the hips to the left. Reach to the right. Inhale through center. Reach up, root down through the right foot, and reach up and over. Side bend. Again, getting into that congestion. Inhale, lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lengthen through the spine. Step or flip it back, chaturanga. Inhale, urdhva mukha. Exhale, adho mukha. From here, right hand grabs around the outside of the left leg. Wrap the left tricep towards the floor, broaden the shoulder blade, and twist. Keep pulling the outer right hip to the right, belly in and up. Use the leverage on the leg. You can start crawling the hand down the leg lower. And then switch sides, right hand, left hand grabs. Wrap the right tricep, grip the floor, and revolve. So we don't want to open through the armpit to collapse through the shoulder. Wrap the shoulder blade around the back. Good. Replace the hand. Take one breath, big inhale, and exhale. Keep your ujjayi working. Lift the heels, bend the knees, look forward, step forward or fly, feet to the hands. Lengthen through the spine, long through the back of the neck, exhale, fold. Inhale, sweep the arms up. Cross the opposite thumb on top this time than you did the last time. Reach up, root through the right foot, going to the left first. Press the hips to the right. Inhale through center. Reach up. Over to the right. Press to the left. Inhale through center. Release the hands. Look up. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lift and lengthen. Ardha Uttanasana. Exhale, Chaturanga Dandasana. Up dog. Heart to the sun. Down dog. Hips to the sun. This time, use the right hand, grab the left leg. Start to heel toe the right foot over to the right. Remember to grab the tricep and start to send the leg up. Super active leg. It's that blade of grass pushing through the earth. Super active leg. Hold here, maybe twist a little deeper. And then release. Hand lowers, leg lowers. Switching side, left hand grabs around the right. Wrap the right tricep. So you've got to have that support in the shoulder and the stability. Walk the left foot over, send it up. You've got to keep that leg active. You can't open the hip or you're going to end up in flip dog. So lift the inner thigh up. Press, see, yep, right there. Press to the heel of the hand. And release. Lower the foot, lower the hand, take a breath. Exhale. Hopefully we're feeling a little bit warmer. Lift the heels, bend the knees, step lower foot. Lengthen, Ardha Uttanasana. Exhale, fold. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, fold back down. Just one more Surya Namaskar A variation. Lengthen through the spine. If you want to find more length in your Ardha Uttanasana, pull the fingertips back towards the feet, heart forward. Exhale, fold. When you find your full Uttanasana, press the fingertips forward and folded. Just some little tricks here. Plant the hands, step the foot back, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. I find myself, I get lazy on Uttanasana and Ardha Uttanasana, so finding a way to deepen those. Okay, from here, right hand is going to grab the right leg, and it's going to hold on. Wrap the left tricep, walk the left leg over, and lift. So same hand, same leg, grip the floor at the fingertips, active legs pushing through the dirt, blade of grass. Good, and lower down. Right hand to the mat, left hand, left leg. Wrap that right tricep. Sweep the right leg up. Press through the heel of the hand. Worst thing that happens is your hand comes down and you flip your dog. Woo! Good, and release. Lower the hand, lower the foot. This time, while we sit and breathe in our downward facing dog, which you can do, or you can come to child's pose, the other option is to take little tiny bunny hops, and they look like this. You'll lift the heels, bend the knees, hop and land with bent knees. Hop and land with bent knees. You'll go back and forth 5 to 8 times. Little bunny hops. Press the ground away, little tiny bunny. Last time, let's hop to the top of the mat. Land with bent knees. Sink the hips down, inhale, chair pose. Tuck the tailbone, bring the shins back. Good, then lower all the way down to the mat. Come all the way down to the back. Send the legs up towards the ceiling. Bring the fingertips back behind the head. So from here, lower the left heel just to hover above the ground. The left hand is going to reach past the right thigh. I hope you can see what's happening here. Right elbow super wide. So 10 times, lower the right leg and lift. Here's 9 and lift. 8. Lift. 7. Here's 6. Keep the elbow open and reach. 5. 4. 3. 2. 1. Bring both fingertips back behind the head. Lift the leg. Right heel hovers. Right arm reaches. Lowering the left leg for 10. And 9. 8. 7, reach, 6, 5, both shoulder blades lifted, open the elbow, here's 3, and 2, and 1, drop the shoulder blades, pull the knees into the chest. From here, we're going to rock up into this deep squat, and on Ashtanga, this is Malasana A, so try to keep the feet together if you can. And I'll show you this from the side and from the front. So we're coming into a baby bakasana, baby crow.
instead of balancing on our hands, we're coming to the forearms. Spread the fingers wide. Bring the knees into the armpits, or you can wrap the knees around the triceps. I find more space if I bring the knees to the armpits. And remember, when we protracted the shoulders today, we're going to do that a lot in this pose. So bring the knees to the triceps. Grip the floor with the fingertips. Press the ground away and suck the heels up. Baby crow. It's almost like you can lift your mat. You're that close. Press through the forearms. Round through the upper back. Heels pull up. And release. Okay, so from the front, we'll do it one more time. So we have two baby bakasanas. Forearms down. Either squeeze or into the armpits. Press the ground away. Rock the weight forward. Look forward. Don't look between the hands. Look forward. And then press them round. Pull the heels up. Breathe. Good. And release. After you release, step back. Make chaturanga. Upward facing dog. Downward facing dog. Okay. We're going to start this fun flow. But before we do, take a big inhale through the nose. Open the mouth, exhale. Okay, inhale, sweep the right leg high. Lift the left heel and step the foot in between the hands. Lift up onto the fingertips from a runner's lunge. From our runner's lunge, we're gonna pistol the leg through. So you can use the support of the hands, you can use blocks or something to give you a little lift, but you're gonna bend, so you're kind of springy. Get it, springy. And then lift the hips, sweep the leg through. But try not to land on the glute, try to keep the leg lifted. Okay, we'll do it again. Step it back. Springy, lift the hips, weave it through. From here, lift the heel. We're coming into a toe stand. Left leg is lifted, squeeze the knees together, and maybe one hand and then the next. Sweep the right leg up and back through leg dog. Okay, from here, right knee, right tricep, squeeze, touch it. Inhale, up and back through center. Knee to nose or kiss the knee. Up and back. Knee to left tricep, tap it. Send the foot off to the left. Open up. Follow triangle. Stretch. Stretch the side body, you can make this more of a back bend. Breathe here. And then plant the left hand to the mat. Keep the right foot where it's at. Lift the left heel high. One chaturanga push-up. Then sweep the right leg up and back. Remember that super active three-leg dog? Find that here. That leg that's lifted is uber active. Come forward with the leg lifted. Plank. Chaturanga with the leg lifted. Drop the top of the foot, lift the heart. Downward facing dog. Good. Big inhale through the nose. Big exhale through the nose. Left side, left leg lifts. Lift the right heel, protract the shoulders, step. Pop up onto the fingertips, pull the heart forward. It's that pistol squat through. So bend the knee, get springy. Hips lift. So there's room for the leg to come through. Good, then lift the hips, step it back. Runner's lunge. Last time, so bend the knee. Lift, sweep, that femur has to plug. Lift the left heel. Sit the heel between the sit bones, keep the right leg lifted. Lift the hands to the heart. Squeeze the knees together. It helps to squeeze that in the leg. Fingertips to the mat, hips lift. Step it back, runner's lunge. Hands plant, left leg sweeps up and back. From here, left knee, left tricep, tap it. Inhale through center. Knee to nose, kiss it. Or smell it, inhale, up and back. Left knee, right tricep, tap, send the foot off to the right. Inhale, open. Find that side bend, back bend. You don't have to stay super still in this pose. Hand comes down. Lift the right heel, flex the left foot, chaturanga push-up. That's your IT badger feeling. Sweep the left leg up and back. Active through the leg, plank pose. That lifted leg helps. Chaturanga. Drop the top of the foot, lift the heart. Downward facing dog. Take 3 breaths here. You can drop to the knees if you need a drink or towel off. We'll meet back in down dog now after 2 breaths. Okay, let's come back to dog. We're going to take that a little bit quicker. If you want a little extra challenge, we're going to try to hold the foot in our pistol squat. So, inhale, right leg lifts, heel lifts. Step the foot between the hands. Pop up onto the fingertips. As you lift the hips, grab the foot. Sit down. Keep hold of the foot if you can or like to. Lift the heel and hover to your Arda pistol, toe stand. Okay, then lift the hips up. Step back. Now here's lunge. Hands plant. Inhale, right leg sweeps. Right knee, right tricep, press. Inhale through center. Right knee to nose. I'm starting to sweat. I hope you guys are too. Lift and lengthen. I don't have heat in this room. Knee to the left tricep. Shoot the foot out. Reach it up. Drop the hand to the mat, chaturanga. Press back up, sweep. Ekapada chaturanga, all that means is one leg, chaturanga. Up dog. Downward facing dog. One breath, inhale. Exhale. Left leg high. Step the foot between the hands. Pop up. Onto the fingertips. Again, you can hold the foot or keep using the fingers for support. Lift the back leg. Maybe grab it. Pistol through. Lift the heel. Squeeze the knees. Lift the hips. Step it back. Runner's lunge. Hands plant. Left leg sweeps. Left knee, left tricep. Squeeze it. Inhale through center. Knee to nose, kiss it. Through center. Knee to right tricep. Shoot the foot out, open. Plant the right hand. Chaturanga. Good. Sweep the leg up and back. Ekapada chaturanga. Eka means one, pada means foot. Bend the elbows. Upward facing dog. Downward facing dog. Take some breaths here. 3 breaths or drop to the knees. Maybe it's a child's pose. If you're feeling stuff come up and you need a little more release, take an inhale through the nose. Open the mouth, exhale, let go. Let's take a lion's breath since we're at home and no one can see us. Inhale. Open the mouth, stick out the tongue. One more lion's breath. Inhale. I want to be able to hear you from your houses. Open. Exhale. Let it go. Awesome, you guys. Now, we're going to play with some frog hops. So instead of bunny hops with the legs together, our legs are going to separate in the air. So we're going to inhale, lift the heels, bend the knees, hop, land, and go back. You might surprise yourself. So, 5 to 8. Depending how fast you're hopping, little froggy hops. I know some of you are having fun with this at home. Others of us may be knocking over furniture. Good. Last time, land in Inbalasana. So hop to face you. So in your Malasana, heels in, toes out.
knees and toes point in the same line always. So from here, bring your elbows to the insides of the thighs. Roll to the outer edge of the foot. So you suck your arches up. Lift the toes up. So two things you can do here with your elbows. You can use them to press the knees open, or you can use them to squeeze the knees. You'll feel your pelvic floor lift. And every day we need something different. All of our bodies need something different. So find which one is speaking to you today and breathe. You can close the eyes, make sure you have space through the neck. Make sure the jaw is released. Good, we're gonna twist. So right fingertips over to the right. Tricep to the inside of the thigh, left arm lifts. Stay here, really working the twist, or flip the palms, reach back, bang. Left shoulder rolls up, back and down. Bring your weight back into the left foot. It wants to go to the right, but really pull it back into the left today. Good, just one more breath. Twist, shoulder back, and come through center. Left arm reaches, right arm lifts. Stay here, working the twist, or flip the palms. And bang, I'm snap, crackling, and popping all over the place today. Okay, bring your weight back into the right foot. Roll the right shoulder up, back, and down. Twist. Keep bringing the weight back into the right foot. I promise it will help. Good. Release, open. Come back through center. Sweet relief. Fingertips to the mat. Lift the hips. Turn the toes in. Heels out. Bend the knees if you'd like. Sway. The wind is back. So we just had a lot of compression in the hip flexors. A lot of sensation in the hips. Stuff probably started moving around. So use the wind. Use your breath to move it out. You can even find that slight shake of the tailbone. And it'll start to release. Okay, once again, guys, pop a yogi squat. Sit the hips down, lift the heart up. We're gonna come into that same twist, just add on a little bit. So drop the shoulder in, reach. Left arm lifts, spin the palms and grab. Remember how I was having you bring your weight to the opposite foot? This is why. So you're gonna heel toe that foot over, lift the right heel high, walk it in from here. Start to lift. It's a baby bird of paradise. You know those beautiful plants that are like red and pink and orange with the green stalk and the face looks like a bird? That's what we are right now. Root through the foot, firm in through the hip. Okay, to come out, go slow. Drop it down, widen your malasana. We're back. You made it. Left arm reaches, right arm lifts. Spin the palm, reach back, and bind. Okay, I like to lift my hips a little. Actually, let me walk over here. Lift my hips a little and walk my free leg, my standing leg, over. Lift the left heel, and you might stay there. Or you start to lift into your baby bird of paradise, which is a plant, it's not an animal. Good, okay. Oh, beautiful daffodils outside the window here. Drop the foot and release. Hands to the heart. Beautiful, you guys. Fingertips down, lift the hips. Toes in, heels out, sway. Bring the wind back, call it back in. Find a release. All right, heel toe the feet together. Lift and lengthen through the spine. Again, remember, pull the fingertips towards the feet to find length. And then as you fold, press the fingertips forward. Inhale, sweep the arms up, root to rise. Exhale, hands to the heart. Did I just get light? All right, so I'm gonna walk to the back of my mat because we're gonna step open to the right. So. You all should be in the front of your mat. Take a big, actually a medium step to your right. So it's like you're in a prasarita. Turn the right toes forward. Back of the edge of the left foot is lined up with the mat or slightly in. Arms reach. Trikonasana. Reach the arms forward. Find length through both sides. And then drop it in. Don't worry about this bottom hand today. I want you to focus on melting through your left side, lengthening through your right. Spin the palm. Drop it back behind like you're putting it in your right back jean pocket, or grab the inside of the thigh. Again, here we are. Left shoulder rolls up to the ear, back, and shimmy the shoulder blade down the back. Melt through both sides. Micro bend the right knee. I just saw in hyperextending. So make sure, press through the ball of the right foot, micro bend the knee, activate through the front of the leg. Once you're stable, start to reach the right arm forward like you have a tray, a platter. Yesterday it was a pot of gold. You were holding a pot of gold and reaching it towards someone. Hold here. Good. Notice if you're shaking. It's all good. Left arm's going to release. Reach it over the ear. Hold for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Inhale. Open the arms. Right toes turn in, left toes turn forward. Line up the feet. Super important. Reach. Scooch back. Reach with the left arm. Find all the length you can before you dive into the pose. So, iron out the right ribs. Lengthen out the left ribs. Like someone's got a hook in your armpit, like a cane, and they're pulling you forward. Okay, right arm lifts. Spin the palm. Bring it back to the left back jean pocket or inside of the thigh. Once you have what you have, bring the shoulder to the ear, back, down. Remember to lengthen, micro bend that front leg, activate through the whole leg. Left arm lifts. Good. Long through both sides. Reach that pot of gold or whatever it is. Maybe it's a bouquet of flowers. And then release the right arm and reach. Hold for 5. You're rotating open. 4, 3, 2, 1. Inhale. Good. Turn both toes forward, hands to the hips. Hop back to the top of the mat. For filming's sake, this is the top of my mat. I'm going to face you. Walk the feet so they're wider. They're about your mat width, wider than the hips. Lift the heart. Exhale, folded. Bend through the knees. So get soft through the knees. Reach the right arm through like you're going to shake someone's hand. Left arm lifts. Spin both palms, reach back, and bind. Once you have the bind, left shoulder rolls up to the ear, back, and down. Our shoulders and our hips near each other. Heel toe, the left toe in, the right toe in until you're about hip width apart. Press the knee against the tricep. Roll the shoulder back so you're twisting here, and you're working towards straightening both legs. But you should feel a little bit of that pressure on the right shoulder, opening through the left. Good. Heel toe the left foot over to the left. Unbind the arms. Bend the knees, fold. Maybe shake or sway. Second side. Reach the left arm through. Shake someone's hand. Right arm lifts. Spin the palms. Reach back and bind. So once you have the bind, shoulder moves to the ear, back, and shimmies down the back. And then heel toe, the right foot over hip width. Press the knee into the arm like you're trying to straighten your legs, which probably isn't going to happen. Keep that shoulder rolling back. Twist. Breathe. Spine. Pull the fingertips towards your shoulders away, and then exhale, pull the press the fingertips away. Inhale, sweep the arms up. Exhale, hands to the heart. hopefully you're still with me. I'm going to walk to the top of the mat now because we're going to take a big step to the left. So hands to the waist, bigger than the last step. So big wide step to the left, toes in, left toes forward. Arms reach, bend the knee. So warrior two, we're coming into an extended side angle variation. So from here, I want the left arm, either the forearm down, or the left hand to the inside of the foot, right arm lifts. If the hand is to the inside of the foot, use the arm to press the knee open. Outer left hip presses forward and back. Spin the right palm, bring it to the back pocket, or the inside of the thigh. Shoulder rolls up, back and down. Lots of prep for our hips and shoulders, yeah? So from here, we've got that tray again. Reach the tray forward. Reach both sides, body is long. Press the hip in, release the right arm, reach for five, four, three, two, and one. Inhale, arms open, leg straightens. Right toes turn forward, left toes in. Bend the knee, warrior two. Shoulders down, so it's either your forearm or the right hand to the inside of the leg. So drop it in, find your pose. The side, both of our sides are long here too. Spin the palm, bring it to the low back, to the pocket, to the inner thigh. Press the knee open, spin the hip in. Left shoulder lifts, rolls back and down. So you're twisting, there's a revolution, you're in your hips, your shoulders, it's a lot. Okay, from here, reach. Maybe that gives you a little more reach and a little more pressing of the hip. And then extend the left arm. Hold. Five. Four. Three. Two. One. Inhale. Turn both toes in. Hands to the waist. Step it to the top of the mat. Again, this is my top of the mat. Bring your feet as wide as your mat. Lift the heart and fold. Okay, soften through the knees. We're coming into a full, mature, adult bird of paradise. So knees soften. Reach the right arm through. Shake someone's hand. Lift the left arm up. Spin and clasp. From here, left toe, heel toes over. Bend the knee. Lift the right heel. That shoulder's rolling up, back and down. Come to the big toe of the right foot. Bend the left knee and power up through your hamstring to lift. So here's the most important part of this pose today. It's going to be the extended leg. The extended leg is going to have power and energy. Doesn't matter if the leg is straight, but it's going to be activated. So it can be here and you can tell it's activated. It's going to shake. Those of us that are starting to straighten, super active leg. Like if we were going to move our arms, it would stay up there, wherever it is. Okay. To come back out, lower down, step to the mat width, release the arms, fold. Sway. So that was our full bird of paradise. We often get into it from our extended side angle, just a little bit different today. Left arm reaches, right arm up, spin. Heel toe that right foot over. Lift the left heel, come to the ball of the foot, bend the right knee. Sit the hips back, use the hamstring, and lift. Once you have your balance and you're lifted, your left leg, it's going to be that blade of grass, and it's going to push through the dirt. It's so active. It's a flower. It's a tulip pushing through. Super active. Hold here. Wherever you're at, even if the knee is bent, power it up, shake, and then come out slow. Drop the foot. Release. This time, really allow yourself to release and sway. Shake through the head, the neck, let the shoulders release. If you lost your breath, come back. Fingertips to the mat, heel toe the feet in, bend the knees, sit down.
So you'll be sitting at the top of your mat, hopefully. We are coming to our peak pose. So we just did a lot of the actions. We're just gonna do it a little bit different now. So we're gonna cradle our right leg. Either the foot to the elbow around the foot, or forklift. Bring the elbow to the knee pit, and then the other elbow closer to the ankle. Pull the shin in towards you, sit up nice and tall. Whichever you feel the most sensation and feels the best, you can find that swaying. Sit up tall, pull the shin in. If you have time at home, you can always take a pigeon in between this, but I think the video is only 1 hour, so we're gonna bust through. So a pigeon for 3 minutes would be really lovely. Okay, so once you've opened your hip, press the knee out to the right, lift the shin up, press the knee out. So instead of pressing back to lift, press out. So that femur is gonna slide into the hip. There's gonna be space. Take the right thumb, split your calf muscle, bifurcate your calf muscle, and lift. Press it out and lift. Hook the calf on the shoulder or anywhere on the tricep. Hook it down so you don't need arms. Okay, from here, fingertips can go to the mat. Remember that super active leg? This is compass with no hands. Lift the leg up. Hands can go to the heart. If you want an added challenge, left leg goes out forward like a bridge, but go a little bit wider than you think. I'm gonna turn. Hands come down to the mat. Sweep the hips up. That leg is strong. Hips lift. So it's like a no-handed compass mixed with reverse tabletop. Okay, we'll switch sides. Shake it up. We're so close, guys. Okay, cradle this left arm or this left leg or forklift. Get that elbow right in the knee. If you're forklifting, it gives the joint nice space. Rock from side to side. Sit up tall. If there's somewhere where you feel a sticky point, stay and breathe. Stay and breathe. So cleaning out our garage and our junk drawer kind of sucks. It's not super fun. It takes time, patience, sensation. So here we are, cleaning out our junk drawer, shoulders and hips. Okay, grab the heel, press the knee out to the left, lift the calf up. Press it out and lift. Split your calf muscle so it flattens, and hook it. Okay, so hook it where you can. Fingertips come down. Here's the energy. It's that flower blooming, pressing through, finding its true potential, lifting up. Lift the heart up. If you're moving on, I'll show from this angle this time. Foot comes forward, hands to the side of the hips. Lift the leg, press. Sweep the hips up, like a reverse tabletop. A lot of times you need to adjust this knee or this foot so it's the ankle's under the knee. Okay. And we release. Good job, you guys. Okay. Find downward facing dog. Come forward onto the belly. Okay. Reach the right arm diagonal on the right shoulder, left hand supports. And flip over your shoulder. Open through the shoulders here. Pull the shoulder blade down and back. If you can, press through all five fingers. Breathe into your shoulder. Breathe it a lot. Just one more breath. Roll back onto the belly. Switching sides, left arm in a diagonal. So the arm is here. Not here today, not up here. Like a wide Y or V. Good, roll over. You can rest the head on a block or the mat or a blanket or a pillow. You're at home. Probably have lots more props. Press through all five fingers. Pull the shoulder blade down the back and breathe.
One more breath. Good. Go back onto the belly. Press, actually stay on the belly. Just wind down your asana. Uncurl the toes, bend the knees. Grab the outside edges of the feet. It's not going to be your deepest on your asana at first. We're holding for 8 breaths, so do the best you can. Kick the feet to the hands, lift. 1, 2, 3, 4, halfway. 5, 6, 7, and 8, release. Press the hands into the mat, child's pose. Press the hips back, shake from your tail. If you take pigeon somewhere in this practice, maybe it's after, shake from the tailbone in your pigeon. Feels really good. Good. From here, an inversion. So our inversion, because we use that super active leg to get up, to lift, we're going to use it to lift us up into our inversion. So either Shirsasana A, B, if you're practicing forearm stand pincha, you can use it here too. I'll just demo it in B, just to demo. Hands come to the mat, the head, crown of the head comes down. We're going to lift one leg. That leg is pushing through the grass, pushing through the grass, pushing through the dirt to lift the bottom leg. Okay, come down the same way. Super active. Keep this. Lift it, lift it, lift it. And then you'll switch sides. Lift the top leg. Super active, active. Lift, 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 lift. You can hold in between maybe 30 seconds on each side. Use one leg, get up, 30 seconds, 5 breaths. Use the other leg, get up, 30 seconds, 5 breaths. Child's pose for 3. Pressing the forehead into the mat. I wish I could help you guys. It's my favorite thing to see you guys succeed in your inversions. It's really beautiful. So after your 3 breaths in child's pose, we're coming to our backs. So roll all the way down each vertebrae. Find happy baby pose. Open the knees wide, soles of the feet up. So instead of pulling the knees close to the ribs today, take the knees out. So the heels really turn in, toes out. Notice if that feels any different. You can rock from side to side. Still working into those hips. Keep breathing, letting the breath move through them. Good. Cross the right leg over the left, cross wrap twist. Bring the left toes down, lift the hips, roll to the outer left hip and drop the knees to the left. I like to take my arms into a goal post, press the right shoulder blade down. And breathe. Exhale, pull the knees up through center and cross. Maybe lift the legs up, shake them out, arms up, shake them out. Do whatever you need to do. Just let it go. And then Shavasana. If you have time to take 3 to 5 minutes or even longer in your Shavasana, highly suggest it. Before you completely start to download all that we just did, just keep your